The next topic we are going to discuss is principles of management. So in the principles of management, we have two types of principles. One is scientific principle and the other one is modern principles. So the first one is scientific principles and the second one is modern principles. So here under the scientific principles, we have 5 principles, and under modern principles, we have 14 principles. So when they ask for 5 mark, we have to write any 5 to 6 principles in each of the cases. And first one, we will move on to the scientific principles. In there, the first one is science, not the rule of thumb. So the meaning of the word rule of thumb is the decision taken by the manager as per their personal judgment. So the decision should be based upon scientific inquiry, which causes effective relationship. And the second one is harmony, not discord. So meaning of the word harmony is good relation. So here it has given, there must be a proper and complete good relation between the workers and the management. If there is no good relation among the worker and the management, so then there will be a conflict or fight between the two, and both will not be benefited by this principles. And the next third one is mental revolution. So revolution means changes. So the technique of mental revolution involves change in the attitude of the workers and the management towards each other. So both should realize the importance of each other and should work with full cooperation. And fourth one is cooperation, not individualism. This means this principle is extension of the principle harmony, not discord, and it stresses the mutual cooperation between the worker and the management. And the last one, that is the fifth one, is development of persons to the greatest efficiency. So now how to develop the persons? By providing proper training to the employees. So and consider their essential in an organization. So these are all the 5 principles of scientific management. Now we will move on to the principles of modern management. As I told you, there are 14 principles of modern management. So in that, the first one is division of work. So according to this principle, the whole work is divided into small tasks, and the task must be given to each and every employee according to their talent or according to their skill. So this division of work increases productivity. And the next one is authority and responsibility. So this is your 2-mark question. What is mean by authority? So for this you can write the answer: the rights of the superior to give order to his subordinates, and the responsibility means the obligation for performance, the responsibility of the manager and the employee towards their work. And the next one, the third one, comes discipline. So the discipline, we all know, it is obedience, proper conduct in relation to each other. So each other means the management and the workers. Next one is unity of command. So this principle states each subordinate should receive order from only one superior or from only one boss. So if the worker receives the command or order from 2 or more superiors, so then it may lead to confusion and it may lead to conflict. And the next one is unity of direction. So unity of direction means there must be one plan and also there must be one superior for each and every group of employees.